And this is an update on the avalanche in the Pakistan state of Jammu and Kashmir, Siachen sector. It's the last update I've received, and it's from the 7th of the 4th. The military faced a looming disaster on Saturday after an avalanche crashed through a remote mountain base containing 135 people, setting off a high-altitude rescue scramble that lasted 18 hours and has yielded no survivors. Helicopters, sniffer dogs and hundreds of troops search for survivors at the Gayari base, which is located deep in the Himalayas near the Indian border, and is now buried in a snowdrift 70 feet deep, the military said. By late Saturday, the military said that 124 soldiers and 11 civilian employees were missing. None had been recovered. Hours earlier, the military spokesman described the difficulties of mounting a rescue operation at an altitude of 15,000 feet amid freezing temperatures. He said, "We are using all our resources. Hundreds of troops are involved in the rescue operation." The military said it was airlifting engineering equipment from its headquarters in Rawalpindi because of the very difficult, treacherous terrain. The rescue operation was expected to last several days. The disaster did, however, underline the inherent dangers of fighting on the world's highest battlefield. Gayari is on one side of the 49-mile-long Siachen Glacier, which has been violently disputed by Pakistan and India since 1984. Little fighting has broken out there for almost a decade, but thousands of troops are stationed on either side, facing greater peril from extreme weather conditions and dangerous terrain than from the enemy fire. The temperature often drops to minus 40 degrees, and soldiers camping in igloos at elevations of up to 22,000 feet must contend with altitude sickness, high winds and frostbite. The battalion headquarters at Gayari was established 20 years ago and is the main gateway through which Pakistani troops and supplies reach smaller bases overlooking the Siachen sector. The military said that both the location and timing of Saturday's avalanche caught it by surprise. "Since the establishment of the base, no incident of this nature has ever happened," the military said. General Abbas noticed that avalanches usually occurred at night after the sun had warmed the snow and ice, but this one took place at 6 a.m. "It's very unusual," he said. Troops from both countries have been stationed at Siachen since April 1984, when the Indian Army occupied the heights around the glacier. Pakistan responded within weeks by sending in its troops, and both sides exchanged artillery barrages. Despite occasional skirmishes, the area has been relatively quiet since a ceasefire in 2003, with Indian forces dominating many of the higher positions. The link to the article, the rest of it, is below. Thanks, YouTube.